Start.
Okay, I'll try this again. So Todd, you put it on, yeah?
Let's let it run, why not?
Yeah, people love seeing me, I'm saying. Just, even if I'm not doing anything, maybe I just can't get enough.
This is such a glow to it.
Amazing. Okay, so there was a pasuk in the Torah. Just go ahead for my car keys. There's a pasuk in the Torah, Yeah, kli gever al isha. There should not be kli vessels of men, big boats on women. No, there shouldn't be any men's ornaments, I should say, al isha, val yilbash gever, simlas isha, and a man should not wear the clothing of a woman. It's a disgusting thing to Hashem, anybody who does this, okay? Like you're trying to be comparable to a man, in order to go amongst the men. It's only the purpose of it is l'shem niyuf, which is adultery. Why would a guy ever dress up in women's clothing? Obviously, to sit amongst the ladies. We're going to get to it. To sit amongst the ladies. Another guy there to the... Another geder, says Rashi, is because one another iser to the another geder to the iser is that a man should not shave places that women shave. We're going to get into all this lahalacha. First, we're going through the Chumash Rashi and a little bit of the Sefer Chinuch and the Chayrev just to give an idea of what this Isser is. Kitoy Avas, Le'asra Taira, which is going to be a big kicker when it comes to the halacha point. Elo Levush HaMevi Lidei Taiva. A clothing that brings a person to Taiva. Okay? There we go. Let's look on the right. Sefer HaChinuch. Levush Isha Eide Ish. Shalei Yilbashu Anashim Amushi Anashim. Right? Women should wear men's clothing. Lo'i Yazinu Be'ezinam. Women should not walk around. Now, there are people who bring lahalacha, this pasuk, when there are women in the IDF. A gun, some might say, is a man's ornament. Right? They have a shiloh, whether or not a radio, that's all a radio, is a tachshit or a malbish, negel the Shabbos. Some people just love the look of the radio on the belt. It might not be something actually necessary. But some might say that a gun would be a kli gever. And that's the reason why women shouldn't go to the army. There are many other reasons why girls should not go to the army, but that could be one of them. Okay, beautiful. We're going to skip a little down. She'ain derech isha right before the highlight. She'ain derech isha ba'olam latzeis l'chli zayin. It's not normal for women to go out with the tools of war. Aval hu'adin she'asur lehem midai ra'isa latzeis l'albushim she'derech ha'anashim ba'oisei ha'makam v'shtamish behem. Ready, Sefer Chinuch gives a little inkling. It is usher for a woman to dress in men's clothing in that place. So we see from here a little bit that it's going to depend where you are, what will be the gedder of the Isser. Okay? Let's look at the Chayrev. He brings out a beautiful view. It's not really la halacha. He brings out a view why there's such an Isser. Hashem separated between Zacharim and Nekevus. I'm sorry if that hurts anybody's feelings. I'm sorry if that people get offended by that. As we all know, the greatest, Demi, they, them. I'm still not changing my English because she decided she's a they-them. I didn't realize she was that fat, that she wanted to be considered more than one person. But she comes out, she's non-binary, and the day the day that her documentary comes out, she finally built up the courage to tell the world she wants to be referred to as more than one person. But HaKadosh Baruch Hu made it, as Ben Shapiro said, doctors do this all day, he's a boy, he's a girl. HaKadosh Baruch Hu made Zachar and a Keva. Every person, every min has a zachar point and a nekeva point. Everywhere in life you can find midas zachar and midas nekeva. I'm going to skip down a little bit. So we're going to skip down a bit. Okay, mitzvah lishmar al havdalah. It's a mitzvah to protect this havdalah, the separation of men and women. On the chitzoniyah, shal zachar nekeva. Okay, so isha tefiyah ki isha ve'ish ki ish. A woman should dress like a woman, and a guy should dress like a man. We still don't know exactly what this means, but we're going to see. He writes, the Chayyav writes, even simple tachshitim, a guy shouldn't wear. A tachshit would be, as Reb Chaim holds a watch as a tachshit. Please enjoy. Thank you, brother. What?
I shock on it?
Please don't. It's like not a covetic thing to do. Reb Chaim holds, and my uncle went to Reb Chaim. My uncle went to Reb Chaim, there's open bag over here. My uncle went to Reb Chaim, and Reb Chaim saw his watch, and people don't know, Reb Chaim is very against watches. He said, it's a tachshit, give it to your wife. So a woman's wear tachshitim. Men would not be able to wear tachshitim. Chazal asu siyag lagvarim asu kalsosot tivuach beginda brevis. Shenashim nohagim boy, that women normally wear. Im einam nikarim emarach itzayni. Even if it's not something that's seen, for example, is the first thing that pops into my head, a belly button ring. Would be mutter for a guy to wear a belly button ring. Obviously, if he doesn't take off his shirt when he goes swimming. Is it okay for him to put that on? Women wear it. Says the Chayreif, it will even be usher even if no one sees it, because Rashi learns that the levush, the holiness of the levush, brings you to taiva. If it's a woman, inherently a woman thing to do, i.e. a belly button ring, I don't know if anybody here has the type of to do that. I'm just saying this would be a good example. An earring, that's nikeres. That's klar going to be aser because everybody sees that. We're talking about something that people, even something that people don't see, will also be aser in this gather, in this halacha of leilbash keres amos isha, even if somebody will never see it. Even underwear. Yeah, no one will ever see it. But that will be an issue of leilbash keres amos isha. Beautiful. Let's go into the Rambam. We're gonna skip to them to the what's it called, to the highlight. Well, the ish adi isha, we mentioned our women's clothing. Kigun shiyu bashpigli tzvainin, very colorful clothing. Machalizav b'magim shein loyush naisan akelim ei mashim oisay achali ela nashim akol minig hamadina. Rambam says very clearly, this is all according to minig hamadina. What do women wear? Whatever women wear in that medina, you'd not be able to wear. Lamashal, I'm giving. This is. I am not passing la halacha on this. There are more modern communities where men wear a wedding ring. It's such a thing. Whether or not that in itself is going to be a problem, we'll have to see. But if that guy from a more modern community comes into Lamushel Lakewood or Flatbush, Bedairoi, yeah, then L'chaira, he would not be able to wear his ring. He would have to take off his ring when he comes into Lakewood. Because Rambam says it goes kafim minik hamakim. Wherever you are, that's what will make a difference whether or not you're allowed to wear this item. Obviously, something in Karas, as we're going to say. What? Chaim holds what?
The watches.
But the watch, that what? He holds the tachshit altogether.
Right, but I'm saying, but nowadays, men, tons of men wear watches.
Right, Reb Chaim still holds it's considered a tachshit, because the watch is inherently a tachshit of an isha. That's what Reb Chaim holds. Reb Chaim didn't say anything until after his shver Reb Eliashiv died, because Reb Eliashiv wore a watch. He didn't say anything about watches until after Reb Eliashiv died. Very interesting. Okay, very good. We're going to go down. Mishar Shem Mitzvah. It ain't Suffolk down, again, down by... When a guy wears women's clothing, he's more inclined to go to do niyav, to do dvar avera, to do dvar iser erva. Okay, so we have to stay far away from it. Like Rashi said, it brings you to the taiva. Look at the highlight. Because if everybody, this is a very powerful line, if everybody wore the same thing, there will be no difference between men and women. Which is what the world is trying to do now. There are no differences in men and women. That's what the world will tell you, right? Except, if you look at them, there are inherent differences between men and women. Yes, maybe they should get equal pay. Maybe they should not be subjectified and objectified. That's all beautiful, but there are inherent differences between men and women. If everybody's shopping in the same stores and doing everything the same way, talking the same way, look what's going on. Guys who talk like girls, who are they? They're the birds in San Francisco. They're trying to be like females. That's what they're trying to do. That's going to be an issue. And L'chaira talking like that would also be a problem. Because maybe they're taiva. L'chaira, one could say, talking like a girl might fold this mouth. Again, not la'alacha. We're talking about malbushim here. Okay? So you should be careful not to, that there has to be a separation of the sexes when it comes to dress, and when it comes to clothing, because that'll make a big nafkamina. The whole point of the Isser is to tell you that you should separate men and women, and everybody dressing the same will be a problem, okay? That will be another problem for women serving the IDF. I don't know if you guys get this yet, but I'm a little against women serving the IDF, okay? So just some I wonder, and what I am, okay? That is another reason why I have to be marchik. Look at the Shulchan Aruch on the left side. You're there, Simon Kuf Pei Beis, which is the famous Simon on Layil Bashgever. Hamar Vishar Beis Hashachah Beis Erva Afilu Mizraim Ke'en Tar Hayu Mechen Oisei Magas Mardis. You're not allowed to shave certain places that women shave, even if it's not such a close shave. Why? You're there to give me a malchus. But my department, we're in the makim she'im avir yisrael l'nashim. In a place where only women shave in that place and men don't. Al makim she'im avir yisrael gam ha'anashim im hevir ein makin yisrael. Now, hold on a second. There's in a place where men also shave in that spot. I'm going to give an example in a second. Im hevir ein makin yisrael. You don't give him malchus. Does that mean it's okay to shave in that spot? L'mashal, armpits, let's say. Women shave their armpits. Let's say you're in a place, San Francisco, yeah? Let's say you're in a place where men shave their armpits also. So now, would you say it's mutter to shave your armpits? Or would you say, ain't makin isai? We won't kill you for it. We won't give you malchus for it. Yeah, we won't drive you crazy about it. But I would assume from the lashon of the Shulchan Aruch says you shouldn't do it. Because it's a woman thing to do. Happens to be men do it also. Yeah? So I would think the same thing for the wedding ring. Most men do not wear wedding rings, at least in the firm world. We're going to get into whether or not it applies if it's a manly thing by Jews or manly thing by non-Jews. We're going to get to that. But let's say that we're going with manly thing by Jews. A wedding ring would fall into that category again. A wedding ring will tell you that, yes, women wear it for sure, and a lot of men wear it too. Men wear it. It's not an uncommon thing that men wear. So that'll fall into ein makin isai. Again, people might hurt me after this because their followers are wearing it. I don't care. I'm going to the halacha. Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, also Gufayim Beis. Aslus Lilbash Avil Malbush Echad Shalisha. Now, you might say, hold on, maybe Lilbash Geres Alas Isha, maybe the Taiva will mean they have to dress completely with a blouse, a skirt, tights, and high heels, yeah? No, even one article of clothing. Even if it's nicker on the rest of his clothing, and he's a man. Same thing for a woman to wear one thing manly. Again, he goes on to the same point of whether he goes on the minig hamakim. Well, women beautify themselves with, it is also for a man to beautify himself with. The king called Mashim Yuchil Ish, Aslish, anything that's me Yuchil for a guy will be Usher for an Isha.
I have a question.
Yeah.
Could a guy, does it mean the actual article, I don't know who was made for, take a hoodie for example.
Oh, we're going to get to that.
Some are made for men similar.
We're going to get to that when we talk about pants. Okay, we're going to get to that because Lamaisa, he just brought it up, so I'm going to go with that. I wasn't going to go into it right away, but I'm going to go into it now quickly. There was a Shaila brought to, I'm trying to remember which Pesach it was. I don't remember which Pesach it was, but it was a competent Pesach. I'm a nurse. I work in the hospital, and I'm mechuyev to wear scrubs. I have to wear scrubs in the hospital. Can I wear scrubs? Pants. He said, get a size bigger than you need to wear and tie it by the waist tighter. So it doesn't show tightness of your figure, of your clothing. He said, by the way, that might be more tsunua than wearing a skirt. Well, yeah. If a person's going to wear a tight skirt or wear baggy pants, if you say that the whole vert is that you shouldn't maybe lead a taiva, then it might be better to wear the pants. But if you're going to tell me that pants is inherently, at least for Jewish, if you go with the Jewish barometer, that pants is inherently a man's thing, no matter how baggy the pants are on a girl, it'll be us because pants is what a man wears. Yeah? So we're going to get to that together in a second. Okay? We'll go right there. I feel it's all at the bottom. Go for it, make noise, it's okay. Is the bottom of the story, so now pull out a white. To pull out a white hair. Where's the dam? I need to tell him this. The person now will pull out a white hair amongst the black hairs. Shazehu na'isha, because that is what an isha does to beautify herself. But also, mishum la'yobash kever. It's us because this is a la'yobash kever. It's also us to dye your white hairs black in order to look younger. There was a yid in my shul who would dye his hair, his beard, black because he wanted to look younger. And the rav yelled at him, and the next Shabbos he came in with a full white beard. He had to dye it white. He didn't have a choice at this point. So he had a full white beard. Beautiful. So, what is practically what a person has to do to be over this iser? If you turn over the page, people with those have papers, and those who want papers who don't have, there's more papers over here. Okay. There's a three-way machlekes, which I'm quoting from the Shevet Alevi, but he made that machlekes. If somebody wants, Mordechai, if you could fix the camera. It is a three-way machlekes. It's okay. Yeah, it's a three-way machlekes, the Beis Yosef, the Bach, and the Shach. I just brought it down over here. It goes 1, 2, 3. I just split it up. I chopped it up so we can see the sheet is a little clearer. But it's brought down the Shevet HaLevi. I thought it would be a little simpler to be on the Shevet HaLevi than to go through the three different places. He brings it down very beautifully. Okay? Excuse me. Says the Beis Yosef. That's what he says. Baruch the Gam Rebbe Elazar ben Yaakov. I feel a be'echen al bush. I feel me keres b'shar shehi isha asur min ha'Torah. A woman to wear one article of clothing that even though she clearly is a girl, and that is me asur min ha'Torah. Right? One article of clothing is going to be the Dereisa of Leobash Gever Samos Isha, Leo Kli Gever Al Isha. That is the Shita of Beis Yosef, the most machmir. Comes along the Bach, and the Bach says, read this Bach over here, it's the one in the middle. Even if you change all your clothing, Ein Aser Min HaTorah, the Dereisa, is going to be Rak B'Yesheves Bein HaAnashim. You're only wearing these clothing in order to hang out with the guys in hot clothing and hang out with the guys. Avaloi Etzim HaLevisha. It's not on the clothing itself. It's on what you do with the clothing, right? You dress to kill, right? You dress to fight.
Dress to impress.
Dress to impress. Very good. So she's going to dress like that in order to sit with the guys. That'll be the Isser. It's not only on the clothing, it needs to have that social component as well. Comes along the Shach. The Shach is the most makel. Says the nearer the inner Isser bebeged echad. He holds one article of clothing is not going to make it or break it. But if your mom is dressing up, you're putting on a few articles of clothing, you're trying to impress guys, even without the social component, that dressing up will be the issue of Leil Vashkar Vashimos Isha. That is going to be the problem. Okay? What about, so that's a three-year machlekes how we're going to deal with this. Now, what about, I'm going to give you an example. Mishra will all be married one day.
Amen.
Thank
Amen.
You. Amen. And your wife is walking down the street with her pakabuk, and she's also carrying her groceries, and you're obviously holding your gemara, you can't hold anything else. But your wife is mamish slapping all these bags, obviously down Rechov Saratskin, and she says, do you mind holding my purse? I don't want it to drop, I'm carrying all these bags. Are you allowed to carry her purse now?
Yes.
Yeah,
because
we're not
doing it.
With her.
People can tell
her. Shit! Yeah.
Tell who's
in the fire show, whatever. He opens the door too. Okay, so it will be a problem. What? So according to Shitas Rashi right away, it's not maybe Lidei Taiva. And it's not clear that it's maybe Lidei Taiva. Fine. Let's say my wife is not with me and she asks me to bring it to her in her office. And I'm carrying your bag. No one knows whether or not why I'm doing it. So you for sure have a problem with Marasayan. For sure a problem. And you put it over your head like that, you know, exactly like the woman walking with it. And you're walking down Rechov Saratskin like that. Okay? Men usually don't, except for Joey with the man bag. Men usually do not walk down with such a zach. Yeah? According to the Beis Yosef, that will be a problem with Yobashkever, because he holds one article of clothing, of women's clothing, will be an issue. According to the Bach and the Shach, it will be no problem. Right? There'll be no problem. Why? Because you're not doing it for something. The Bach holds you need a social component. The Shach holds one article of clothing does not define that you're dressing like a girl. Okay? That'll be another issue. Okay? We're looking at the Aruch Chaim now. What about Purim? I was walking in Ramat Beit Shemesh on the first day of Purim. Only in Israel you can say the first day of Purim, the second day of Purim. Now, there was a group of seminary girls coming towards me. I obviously wasn't looking, but there was one girl that stood out because she was wearing a costume. I know it was more not sneezed for not wearing a costume because she was standing out. But I'm curious why she was wearing a costume. And she was wearing a t-shirt that said, Yetzer Hara. And like, she won the award. Like, she won like the best costume ever. Yeah? Ramat Beit Shemesh on Purim. The Surim, the Murim. Okay, so...
Remember what street this was?
This was on Nahal alone. That's at my cousin's house. Okay, so what about Purim? Is a guy allowed to dress up like a girl on Purim? Says the Ramah and the Gain. Oh, it's a bad place to be. Says the Ramah.
Are there any
yeshivas
around there?
No. Says the Ramah and the Gain that the reason why you would dress up like a woman on Purim is for Simcha. You're not doing it to try to impress the girls, except like Rav David Alasky said a Maisa where a guy dressed up like a girl and he was in his house and a seminary girl came to give him Shlachmanis and she's looking up and down at this guy and he mouths like it's a girl and she looks at him and she says, where did you get those shoes, right? But up Purim, you're not going to be dressing up like a girl in order to get with the girls. You're dressing up because it's hysterical when a guy dresses up like a girl. Says the Ramah and the Gain, there'll be no problem with dressing up like a girl on Purim. Comes along the Bach, and the Bach says, absolutely freaking not. Why? He says, because the Isser, he says the Isser, you're right, the Daraisa is in order to sit or hang around with girls. That 100% is the Isser. But the Darabanan is also wearing clothing. There's still a Darabanan aspect of wearing women's clothing, and Darabanans, much to contrary belief, still apply on Purim. You cannot be over the Isseri Darabanan, even on Purim, and he holds the Isser. There was a guy last year in Beis David, I'll show you guys a picture, it's on my phone, I'll show you guys a picture afterwards. He looks like a feminine guy. We all know those guys, I'm saying. He looks like a feminine guy. And he put on the new, what are they called? Leggings. And girl shoes, like whatever. And like a low mini skirt. Mamas not snua. A sweatshirt, a seminary sweatshirt. A wig and like one of those like flappish lady caps. You know what I mean? Like one of those like the leather caps, whatever. The guy looked like a girl. Like the guys who were coming in looking at him were trying to hit on him. He looked like a girl. Yeah? And then Weizenfeld told me. Weizenfeld told him.
Boogie.
Oh, so Larry almost called. Walter told the Jeff Dunham that when he was younger, he should chase skirts all over the world until he got to Scotland, and he was surprised. Anyway, so, okay.
Everyone skirts in
kilts. Weizenfeld told him, you have to leave a few hairs. You cannot shave completely, because he's mamish, you cannot tell. I'll show you guys a picture after.
I know what.
Actually, you do. He was in Tveris Shmuel. We'll talk after. Okay? No, it was not Yitzi, because Yitzi, you could tell that he has a beard. You could tell that he's clean shaven. I told you could tell that he's clean shaven. It was another guy. We're not going to do this now, because I'm on camera. Okay? But he mamish, Weizenfeld, you have to leave a few hairs there, so at least there's some nicker that you're a guy. You can't completely dress up like a girl, okay? My uncle, for a number of years, dressed up like a girl, and his kiss would stain you, because he put like globs of lipstick. Like, some people just never mastered the art of lipstick. I, on the other hand, anyway, fine. So,
what did he say?
So, for pants. Do you know what pants? The Tzitz Eliezer Waldenberg, who was a Pisic, who was Nifter about 15 years ago. The Tzitz Eliezer says, any pants made for style is men's clothing. All pants, no matter what, is men's clothing. He thinks that pants objectively is men's clothing. He chose the Avnei Tzedek, who allows women to wear snow pants in the cold, because obviously not wearing men's clothing for it to be a modest, it's for practically. So if a girl goes skiing, very good. A girl goes skiing, snow tubing, snowboarding, what? It's not sneeze. Because it's puffed up as anything, you can't like see anything. A girl will be able to wear that because it's clear why she's wearing it. And that would go for the same thing for the woman in the scrubs in the hospital. It's clear why she's wearing it, not to dress up like a guy, not even to, it's not that she wants to wear man's, she has to wear man's clothing. For her, it's not considered man's clothing. For her, it's the get up for what she needs to wear in her situation. It's not that she's wearing men's clothing, even though pants, according to the Tzitz Eliezer, are inherently for men. The men, like, even though nowadays we have women's pants, pants are pants and pants are automatically for men. That's obviously if you go in the Mahalach that we go regarding Jews, not Goyim. If you go there, we go by Goyim, yes, women wear Goyim, but then you would have a whole different issue of Tznius, not an issue of Le'il Bashkeber Samos Isha.
Like baggy mom jeans, what would those be?
What?
According to the second sheet, the baggy mom jeans.
L'chayra, but then you might have a problem with sneas, unless if it's baggy. Right, if it's baggy, hold on a second. We're in a Korah B'Vadya right now. This is based on who it was made for. If it was advertised for men, then a woman cannot wear it. If it was advertised for women, then a man cannot wear it. We don't say objectively pants are for men. If it's unisex, then no issue. Sports, sweatshirts, sports, jerseys, t-shirts, etc. These are unisex items. Or B'Vadya held that, that if it was made for a woman, this is obviously a Sfarad issue, the Ashkenazim, we do not pass like this. If it was made for a woman, then it will be mutter for, like you're saying, as long as it's sunua, it'll be mutter for a woman to wear. Okay, now we're going to get into a topic. We're going to end with this. What?
Ski pants
will be fine, according to Sister Eliezer, and right place also, because it's not that she's wearing men's clothing. She's wearing snow gear. Boom, they look like pants, or shaped like pants. Yeah, that's what you have to look at it, okay? Okay, let's do about mirrors. What about mirrors? Are you allowed to look in a mirror, okay? Are you allowed to look in a mirror? Clearly from the Gemara, you're not allowed to look in a mirror, except for a few exceptions. One, if you're getting a haircut, you're allowed to look in a mirror to make sure it comes out okay. Or, if you're getting a haircut by a guy, you're afraid he's going to kill you, but you could see him, so he'll have a little bit of a fear, okay? You're allowed to look in a mirror. Why would a mirror be a problem? That's what women do to beautify themselves. Any act that a woman does for taiva, for beautification, men are not allowed to do because men will lead to a taiva for men. In Taisvis, Taisvis holds, if you're applying medication, this comes up a lot of times, if a guy wants to pop his pimple, or, well, you shouldn't pop your pimple, it's not good for you. What?
You see me at night?
No, never. Right? But if a guy's putting on cream, he wants to make sure he gets in the right spot. He's allowed to look in the mirror for that. Because it's clear he's looking in the mirror not to beautify himself, because he needs to look in the mirror to make sure he knows what he's doing. Rabbi Gamliel would meet government officials and have to look respectable. So he would use a mirror to make sure his beard was straight. Or Shlomo Freifeld, when somebody would drive him home, he would pull down the mirror, make sure his beard was straight before he went home to give kavod to his wife. Something very chashuv. If it was the Rabbanon, then it would not make an exception. Rabbi Gamliel did it in order to beautify himself. If it's Isser, is the Rabbanon, I'm sorry, it has to be a Rabbanon. Because if it was the Daraisa, Rabbi Gamliel would never have been over at the Daraisa to give cover for the government, to look clean for the government. So at the Rabbanon, I can hear. Maybe you'll say it's the Daraisa, we're defining the rule. The rule is don't do feminine things. But if you're doing it for something else, i.e. looking good for the government, looking for your wife, that'll be mutters. Is it the Daraisa, the Rabbanon, Machlokes Rishonim, the Ritzvan, the Ran? If it's a culture that men look in the mirror, I would say men look in the mirror nowadays. Guys shave in front of the mirror. Guys always looking, make sure in the morning. As long as you're not going in the mirror, oh my gosh, look how beautiful. As long as you just go in the morning, Mordechai, right? Mordechai does this every morning. He looks, make sure it's clean. He looks presentable because he wants to look presentable for Shacharis. Then that will be okay. Men looking in the mirror to make sure they don't look gross is okay. To making sure that they look beautiful will be the problem. Okay. Nachamayish only is if you're looking to plug out white hair, that'll also be a problem. Nachamayish is very lenient. We're not going to get into that. But it is usher to look into a mirror. Stamazai. The Ramad does not quote the heter for men. There are generally nowadays heter for stains. Interesting that halacha changed based on society. It depends on society. What do men do? Ravad Yosef says even Sfarik and Mekel not pulling out hair is covered at Bria, is covered at Torah. If all from Jews don't look good, it's a lack of covered at Torah. So Jews, it drives me crazy. When you see, again, I'm not being anti-Semitic over here, a little bit. When you see guys coming into Kailul and their shirts are half on top, they have a stain in on their shirt, they're looking like, what? Okay. No, you have to look respectable. Kavod HaTorah is coming in, but say to me, Kain, you look respectable. You're allowed to look in the mirror for whatever you need, just to make sure you look okay. There's no issue with that. If anybody has any other examples that they want to bring up, we got through everything we needed to bring up tonight. If you want to keep the Maariv claimants, it's up to you. If not, it's all good. If you have any questions, comments, or an interesting story that has no relevance.
Yeah, I have an interesting story about just that.
About this?
What do you have to go
a few months ago, I rolled to Mint Clear.
Stop this. No, leave it up.
Listen, I rolled to Mint Clear a few months ago.
With slides on?
I was wearing like slides, sweatpants, a hoodie, like tits and soap or something. And some guy from here, I'm not going to say who, some guy from DVD rolls in here. And he comes over to tell me, you know, really for dancing, you should look more presentable. I'm thinking to myself, dude, no offense, but in my pajamas, I look fresher than you in your freshest clothing.
These
guys are like, I didn't
help him, though,
did you?
I know, I was thinking to myself.
I hope not.
Then I realized, like, he's trying to look fresh, and that's how he looks. This is how
right.
He looks.
Again, so every person, you're right, but it's every person, how they feel is presentable. Certain things should be non-negotiables, like shoes. You should wear shoes for davening. But you could decide sneakers are more presentable, dress shoes are more presentable. That's up to you to decide how you look. If you feel an untucked polo shirt, some nice cotton pants, and sneakers are very coveted for davening, then that is your giving cover for davening. You have to make yourself in that scenario that you look presentable. Hey, Morty, what's up?
I was talking to my father about sneakers specifically. And
yes, men
know,
but sneakers applies to men too, yeah?
Right. And it's not about what you wear. It's about the fact that you're standing out.
Well, that's for women, right? Like the Rambam says, you dress up with colorful clothing.
Because
women wear colorful clothing.
And I don't know the exact halakha, so this is more of a question. But if you're, let's say, at the beach, I know halakha.
Made a bracha before. Yeah?
If you're at the beach and everybody's wearing bathing suits, that means you should wear a bathing suit because you shouldn't stand out?
You shouldn't be at the beach.
Okay, I'm at the beach.
What would you be wearing if not? What would you be? Was it men's beach?
Let's say it's men's beach.
What would you be wearing if not? There was no problem with
a t-shirt.
There's no problem with wearing.
Okay, you're at a mixed beach.
Again, being
that's not the point I'm saying.
I hear what you're saying, but if my son, the problem would be taking off, not putting on. You could put on clothing, and that's more respectable.
But you're still standing out.
So what? For men are allowed to stand out. That's fine.
Okay,
so women would not be able to be there because men and women are women, so it doesn't make a difference. Women can stand out amongst other women.
That's
wouldn't be an issue either way.
Okay.
So you would
look fresh
in
the other boys.
Sorry about one mirror.
Everybody.
You said like the mirror, like
however, like every rabbi gives an example, like let's say you're like, let's say you're wearing like a t-shirt or something to daven, and the rabbi said,